I'm like 13 years old and shit.
Yo, this nigga from a, yo, that's crazy. Yo, you know,
ain't
yo.
No nigga from New York kicking this much flavor.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Man, you lost your goddamn mind down. These niggas is not like me.
You're right. You're right.
That's why this shit works.
You're right. You're right. You're right.
That's why this shit works, man.
Yo, what's up? It's Erick Sermon, the band. You're checking out Thisis50.com. Peace.
Green eyes. This is something that you need to hear. It's cool to capture. I feel like Blondie, caught in the rapture. Rappers and those who try to offend me from false accusations they heard from Windows.
Hello, Erick.
Man, Erick Sermon, man. It's a pleasure and an honor to have you here.
Yes, yeah, so I'm here with the superstar. Mr. Thriller, so-and-so, whatever. I'm surprised I'm on here that he had time for me today because of all the people that he's been doing since me in the last 4 years. I appreciate it. You're blowing up.
Thank you, man. But it's because I was attached to the names like yourself. Legends in the game,
dope,
man.
Dope,
and I
dope.
Really, really appreciate it.
50, you this is a good... You did your thing with this one right here, boy. This right here is to save your company.
Why you said that? I didn't say it. Why are you feeling like that?
Hey, editor, pull it out. Unless if you want to, but man, something that I always want to ask you because I like to ask things from a fan perspective. Yeah. Just like music.
Yes.
Just like music. Uh-huh. No doubt.
Like when you sample some shit like that, right? Do you get a check for that, or is it automatically that's doing this? It's out the window, but it's a good marketing tool to sell the album.
Well, what happened was I paid $150,000 for that sample to begin with. So I was able to get the money back because Clive Davis gave me $4 million. So the investment was dope for me to get the record, get on J Records at the time, but also the wife gave me 35%, and I wasn't even expecting that. She could have took
gave you that.
Yes, she could have took the whole thing from me, but she didn't. So I was
you
able.
Think she knew better?
I don't know. I just think that
you
maybe
you wasn't gonna say shit if she didn't.
Exactly, but I think the fact that imagine you being home in your estate, your husband gets sampled, and all of a sudden there's a cash payout. So she was excited, you know what I mean?
Ah,
so I
she
guess
got that off the rip.
Right.
Okay, mm-hmm. I see what you're saying.
So I guess she was
and she
excited.
She probably needed the fuck out of that place to bury Gordon.
Yes. I don't know, but I know that the whole I saw the brother, I saw the daughter, which is the famous one.
Nona Gay.
Yeah, Nona Gay.
Okay, yeah.
She came with the video shoot.
I know my shit.
Yeah, so Nona came, the brother, Jan, which is the ex-wife, mm-hmm. She came and they all came and again they was excited because again, there's 150 grand sitting there and the lawyer gets his and they get the rest, you know? Mm-hmm. So I guess at the time they was like, yo, give him 35%. And I wasn't even expecting that. So that 35% off of that type of record, I was able to get publishing. Because don't forget, like say if Mario Winans did the I Don't Wanna Know record, whatever, those drums are mine. I made 100 grand off of him just on some drums. So I could imagine what it's like to have percentage of a record that's getting that much airplay. But again, that's how it works in the publishing field.
You a real nigga, man. You know a lot of people sit out here and they won't talk money. You over here educated, because motherfuckers ain't getting that money no more like that.
Nah. I own my publishing, so I'm not the person that had to sell because I didn't need the money at the time. Mm-hmm. Maybe if I was in trouble when I had to sell my publishing, it'd be different. So when somebody is sampling me, it goes to me. So again, that's how I live. You know, I ain't been out in 12 years, Jack. You know,
it's been 12 years.
Yeah, I dropped that mixtape for dropping mixtape. That's free. Mm-hmm. But I've been, my last record was 2002. Mm-hmm. That was React with me and Redman.
Hey, yo, I'm immaculate, come through masculine. Wide body frame, E-dubs the name. Whoa. In the field of rap, I'm superb, I'm fly. I should be in the sky with birds.
But I live off of publishing. I live off of me selling over 75 million records, meaning that.
Why y'all could keep out of that?
Out of what?
Out of the React, man.
I just did that myself. That was just me bugging out one day. So-and-so and Just Blaze had made this record and nobody could figure out what the girl was saying. Mm. So that's why I said, whatever she said, then I'm that. So when it came, it just went. And somebody brought it to Angie Martinez and just blew up. So I didn't have time to even fix it. Mm. That's the original version that we just did playing.
And it worked.
Yeah, it worked, right.
Damn.
Yeah.
Now, you ever had a charm career? There's a lot of people in Atlanta that say your name that I wouldn't even imagine.
Okay, let's go. See, this is why I fuck with this nigga right here. Because I want to let people know about Atlanta, Georgia. I'm the first person to move to Atlanta in 93. Before I got there, it was not like it was now. And my rim shop, which is Peachtree Motoring, mm-hmm. You ask any one of the Millennium people that lived there, any one of the famous people that lived there, my shop was where they came to. In the back of my shop was 112 Jagged Edge, T.I., Goody Mob, even Usher came with the Wrangler truck at the time. David Banner said he got kicked out by Keith Murray from the shop. Tupac, the Dave Justice, anybody that was somebody came to my shop. They was all nobodies at the time. Ludacris, everybody was nobodies. They gave me the key to the city. First of all, I was on the front page of the paper saying Erick Sermon moves to Atlanta. So when I heard the Atlanta story, and my name is not in there, I'm like, yo, who made that story? Because I'm the first person to bring the video camera downtown to shoot Stay Real. I brought Shaq, Jalen Rose, some of the NBA players to the shop. We shut down Peachtree. That was me, the freak nick in the city, the whole nine. All that was me. The clubs was me. Everybody's cars that was being done was done by me. I did TLC's cars. I remember Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis had bought a Land Cruiser truck for Pebbles, whatever. I did Pebbles' truck, put the wood grain in there, and so-and-so drove that truck all over Atlanta. I ain't give a fuck. It was brand new.
Yeah, plus they fucked over TLC, man. You had to go and celebrate that.
I got another surprise.
No, me and Left Eye was cool though.
Word. My own girl. Did you tip off and like, hey man, hey, you know they got a Land Rover, you got this rave right here. What, all of y'all got raves?
No, but listen, when me and Lisa was cool, she had a rodeo. But she was the only one at the time that was getting money because she wrote her own rhymes. So she had some publishing money. So again, me and her was cool.
When she was very smart. A lot of people don't like know.
Yeah, but she was smart though too. But Lisa was also like a dude though too. She was like a dude.
I still hit that.
Yeah, I mean, we, you know.
Oh!
No, no.
Oh! Oh no! You was chasing waterfalls now.
No, no, I'm just saying though, we was cool.
Yeah.
Nah, we was all cool, man. We was cool.
Nigga, that was you?
Nah, listen, man. Atlanta was Georgia back then. Georgia.
Man, yo, you came up, like, you was there around when Freak Nick was Freak Nick.
Yes, it was.
Y'all, tell them what Freak Nick was? Because they don't understand what this Bill Campbell fucked up.
You got to imagine. How you know about that?
I'm from Atlanta.
Oh.
Decatur. Reading High School.
Now, Bill gave me the city. Now, next to my shop was a guy named Hosea Williams.
Yeah.
He walked with Martin Luther King. I used to give him money and give him food and clothes for the homeless in Georgia.
Yeah.
You know the story already.
Yeah.
The Platinum Club, me and my boy Vaunce, so-and-so, we was to go out there and he had the only club that was crazy at the time. Like, we had Death Squad mansions. I used to be in Swanee. I used to have a house in Alpharetta. I used to have cars in the AU. I wasn't even driving then. Friends had them. Like, yo, we saw somebody had posted he got raped in my house. I'm like, raped in what house? Erick Sermon's crib. I'm like, nobody raped you, not in my crib, but like, whatever. But
you invited Bill Cosby over? That's a crazy party. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
No, but Bill was the mayor at the time, and he was a cool dude. But again, he gave me the key. I'm like, yo, I didn't know what that was. I'm like, nah, I'm cool. So I didn't show up for no key presentations. But again, that city, the Freak Nick, you gotta imagine this. A whole city is open to
fucking.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, kinda. You know, I forgot where I was at. Sodom and Gomorrah. But on the streets though, live.
On the street.
On the whole
in the highway.
City in the highways, on down Peachtree, the whole nine. You can do whatever you want to. This is before they start making the pass and cutting stuff off the whole nine. I saw, yo, one time, I don't know
tell
if it
what
was
you saw.
Yo, it was a couple of rappers, Pac, by Mr. Dead, Tretch, all of them. They used to be up to 3 a.m, be like just walking, man. It was, you didn't want to go to sleep.
You didn't want to sleep.
It was Sodom and Gomorrah.
I was up for 4 days straight.
Yo, now me knowing that, you can't take nothing from this nigga. Because while Hot Leonard is Hot Leonard, he was actually there before it got there, period.
Come That's on, just man. That. Before that.
If me and Jack ain't in the story, this shit shouldn't be written.
It ain't written, man. Come on, man.
Don't do no Atlanta movie. Don't put me in it, motherfucker. I funded 97.5. Ludacris and fucking and Chris Love. I put rims on them trucks or they was driving in them cars.
I know you did that. That's crazy.
That's all me.
Damn, man. You feel like you unsung in those areas?
Yeah, that's, you know what? Somebody told me, yo, E, go ahead, talk, man. It's okay.
You so good with it.
Because I was. but now I'm Kanye West in it.
Y'all want to go to Africa? I'm standing up and I'm telling you, I am Warhol. I am the number one most impactful artist of our generation. I am Shakespeare in the flesh, Walt Disney.
you see what he do now, right? Like, people didn't understand why he was doing that.
No, shit. I understand. Now I get it now. That's why I said before. If me and Jack ain't in the Atlanta story with the new movie, because I heard that it's a rumor that they're doing the Rimshot movie right now. They're going over songs or whatever. They called me.
T.I.?
Yeah. So Jack know everything. How does he know this? Yo, T.I. is doing the supposedly doing the Chopping the Rimshot movie, and you know, okay, automatically, since we know what time it is, our phone should be ringing soon.
Man, in real time.
We should get some money. We should get a nice check for the new year coming up.
Come on, man. And in real life, dog, you cannot, that shit can't go forward without us still.
Exactly. No
doubt. Still, come on, man. You know about me, shouter.
Yo, I can't believe you knew about that. You called the right name.
And don't be the broads. Mad cause I'm bagging chicks that look as bad as jiggers. I make seven figures, a rap icon. I'm the one kid in the biz that keep their eyes on me, Superman. I fell from the window. If I fly high, then why drive a Benzo?